Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this session, we are going to see what are the different components of SSIS project. So we have installed data tools, and then we created one new project. So after launching the SSIS project, we need to understand the different components so that our development process will be very simple as that. Let us try to explore it in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification. So now we have launched the SSIS project that is newly created. So let me go through each and every thing over here one by one. So on your left hand side, you can see the different toolbars. As the name indicates, this is where you will do all your ETL process or your regular automation process. Everything is available over here, right? So the ETL process can be done in using a data flow task, and your regular activities like taking backup of a database or moving files, archiving files, these things can be done by your control flow task that is available over here. So this is what, let me explain it much better in upcoming videos, but the different tasks that you can perform using SSIS are available here. Then coming to here, what are this? So let us understand this hierarchy first. So basically, this is your solution file. Solution file is can contain multiple projects. Like over here, this is the solution file. This is one of the project. Similar to this, I can have another project attached to this solution file. So the solution file sits on top of your project file. Where you can find, just go to here and open file folder in the file explorer. You can find it here. You can see here. Over here, that is, this is the file just away from outside your actual project. It will be appearing. This just contains list of file names. Even if you can go and open with some notepad, you can see the connection. It is nothing but it will contain these projects. Okay, so let us go again. So solution file is hierarchy at the top. It can contain multiple projects, and next to it is your project, the actual SSIS project. Okay, so where you can find in the folder structure over here. So you can see DT project. So this is started with the data transformation extension, and now it is called as DT project. So you can see here, this is the project over here which is appearing for you. And under the project, you can see here a lot of other things, project parameters, connection managers, all these things comes next to your project, below your project. So let us take this one. So under this, you have SSIS project. So each project can contain multiple packages where you can define any of the tasks. So this package, say for example, one of the example of loading an employee. So it depends upon how you organize the things. So here in this package, you can contain the loading of employee, and another package you can write loading of product. Or in the same package, in the same package itself, you can write loading of employee here, and next to this you can write product. So it depends upon how you manage the things. So the hierarchy comes like this: solution, project, under this you have packages. So packages, you can write the real logic over here. Let us come back over here. Then something like miscellaneous, or something like, if you do not have something related to SSIS project, you can keep it here. Say for example, you want to add some images or something, you want to store it as reference. If it is not part of any of the SSIS, the DTSX transfer data transformation service extension. And if I remove that extension, you see here it will go and sit here, right? So whatever is miscellaneous, something wrongly you added, that will go and sit here. So this is just for your understanding. This is not much thing to focus on. Forget about it. So basically, this is what you need to understand. You have your packages, solution, project, packages. There comes a connection manager, right? So what is a connection manager? We will see, like, connection is like when you want to do some kind of transformation. Say, for example, you want to move data from Oracle database to SQL Server database. So Oracle, to connect to Oracle, you need to have Oracle connection manager created. That is a connection string created to the Oracle. That is connection one. You need to load into SQL Server. For that, you need to create the another connection. So this is what the connection manager is all about. That is your source and target. You both, you need to create a connection. Then you need to apply the logic over here. And you have a control flow and data flows that we will see it in upcoming sessions. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.